Okay.
You can wait for him to still do his arm thing.
Yeah, I don't have to rush into the biggest thing.
You're good?
66! Oh.
Yo guys, what is up? Max and Outriders video, and today we're going over how I one-shot the hardest, healthiest, tankiest enemy in Outriders as Trickster, and we'll be going over the co-op setup that I was using for this, as well as if you're playing solo, what you can use to do similar damage, not as much, but if you're a single player, solo player, what you can do as Trickster. Now, this is different than my like normal build video because this isn't really geared to like a build to run through expeditions. It's mainly focusing on how to do the single most damage you can as Trickster. I wanted to see how much damage we could really push to, and this video will be breaking it down, everything you guys need to know. If you enjoy the video, if you learn anything new, I really do appreciate a like and maybe subscribing. It helps me out a ton. And with that, guys, let's get right into the video. All right, guys, so let's talk about how I did this much damage. Now, I do not expect anyone to have all the exact same gear as me and all the exact same roles. I have a ton of hours, and I was playing with friends to do these kills, but what I want the takeaway from this video to be is the strategies that you can employ to your solo play, or if you have a buddy or two to play with, what you guys can do to increase your damage and to do the absolute most damage possible. Now, the biggest thing about these one shots that we were doing on Yagok and Moloch that were different from normal expedition running is there is no enemies to kill. There's no buildup. You can't use mods like Killing Spree. You can't use mods like Sharp Eye or Bloodlust, because the goal is to just get in and one-shot, especially on Yagok. Those orbs that he spawns, they don't count as enemies. You can't like get your killing off of them. So you need instant, immediate damage, and there's not that many great choices. There's mods that like you can roll and you're gonna get a bunch of firepower, but that's not that great. And there's a bunch of different like other kind of conditional firepower ones that are okay, but what we found to be the most damage for these one shots, and I'll talk about how you can employ this in solo, but is using mods that are more damage against enemies afflicted by said status effect. Things like Radical Therapy deal more damage to enemies afflicted by Toxic. Ash and Boost deal more damage to enemies afflicted by Ash. And Bullet Kindling deal more damage against enemies afflicted by Burn. Now, we could have put in Bleed and Frozen, but Frozen didn't seem to be very consistent, and no one was using Bleed. So I used those in addition to perks like Captain Hunter and Personal Space and Twisted Fate and Kingslayer. And these status effect mods are multiplicative with each other. They will crank your one-shot damage up a ton. Now, obviously, you're not going to want to be inflicting all of these different status effects to someone solo and using shotguns against them, because it's a lot of weapon switching. You wouldn't be able to keep out twisted rounds. So there are strategies that I will talk about at the end of the video, but first we're going to talk about the co-op setup. Now, for the most damage co-op, Chadley99, our pyromancer, I will have a link to his channel, was using an anomaly debuff pyro build where he was using triple heat wave with 25% debuff or more damage on each heat wave, and then two thermal bombs with 40% each. That was cranking my damage. The technomancer was using a turret build with the both vulnerability mods and some more crit damage on their gear to give me more gun damage when they activated their abilities. I think it's possible, ideally, to do Pyromancer and a Devastator. The Devastator's statue set does not give other characters firepower. Is currently bugged, so we couldn't use that. But Devastator with Despair would also work really, really well. Despair is every time you leap slam, you get 1.5 times more damage against a target. That and the Pyromancer with the Heat Wave and the Thermal Bomb debuffs would be insane. I'll have links to both of those builds in those channels for Pyromancer and Technomancer. But as a Trickster player, for hitting the one shots, because we are capable of putting out so much damage, some of the things that I had to change was I had to switch to Fortress because there's no enemies nearby. There's no enemies to kill. I can't use Killing Spree. I'm not going to use embalmers. Fortress is simply the best damage increase you can put on your weapon. Now you get Fortress Mod from the Death Shield, and it gives you a 43% damage bonus on your armor. There seems to be a lot of confusion with this mod in the community. Fortress is going to give you a ton of damage on anything, on your abilities. It's the number one weapon you should be using for an anomaly build. It gives you damage on your weapon, but it also gives ability damage, but it's not unlimited damage based on your armor. It scales off of the armor of what you're wearing. Using more armor from like skills and stuff is not actually going to increase this, and it's a pretty fair cap. So the amount of armor that we got pretty much full use out of Fortress, and just Fortress alone, honestly, the damage of this mod compares to Killing Spree. It's pretty crazy. You're definitely going to want Fortress for this. And then I was using Gravedigger's Frenzy with Kingslayer. Critical hits on an elite increase your firepower by 32k, and Gravedigger's Frenzy critical hits give me 50% more critical damage. So that's why you saw me shooting at Yagok or Moloch. I didn't hit the crit on Moloch. That's why it was only 42 and not like way higher. But if you can hit the crit, then you're going to have crazy damage with this kind of setup. Gravediggers is global though. So if you do not have a shotgun with Gravediggers Frenzy, you can actually use like a pistol or another weapon. If you proc Gravediggers Frenzy on a different weapon, you can actually switch because it is a global buff to your character. That way you can actually rock even more damage. And this is just like kind of tips and tricks for what you can do to increase your damage on Trickster. Having Gravediggers on another weapon, and then you can rock Fortress plus like anomaly enhancement or whatever thing you want to go for these one shots. Right now I've been using the anomaly effigy as like my mobbing weapon, and the Enoch's blessing is my solo one shot weapon with Fortress and Gravedigger's Frenzy with this mod. Now I didn't need to worry about upkeeping twisted rounds because all of your abilities reset and we were going to kill everything one shot things before there were a ton of adds. So that worked, but we're about to go over the solo setup. But just real quick, this is my abilities that I was using, and this is my skill tree. I spec'd, I changed out of things. I needed more weapon damage. I want to get as much weapon damage. So this is the new skill tree I've been using. This is the skill tree. And then just to hover over my gear real quick, everything was firepower, close range damage, firepower, close range damage, cooldown reduction, firepower, close range damage, cooldown reduction, firepower, skill leech, close range damage, and firepower, close range damage, cooldown reduction. For Trickster, these are the stats you want to prioritize, firepower and close range damage being number one, and then cooldown being the third most important, the third one you want to prioritize. Now, for solo play, if you want to do as much damage as possible, let's talk about it. Okay, so for solo play, you can do this, like, status effect strategy. You can use a weapon such as, like, a Wicker SMG with ultimate ash bullets and ultimate freezing bullets to apply. You can also use the mod anomaly mutation to cycle through status effects to shoot something with like the mind mugger, get a bunch of status effects on someone, and then do as much damage as you can using these like mod status effects. However, it's just not great. It's not super consistent because you're gonna have to constantly switch weapons, and then the rest of the time you're not gonna benefit from those mods if you're playing solo. So what I've been rocking for solo play now is this reload helmet. That means I can keep up twisted rounds forever with Sharp Eye, Radiation Jump, Bloodlust, Twisted Fate with 30 crit, Move Groove, Captain Hunter, Personal Space, and Stare Into the Barrel Emergency Stance. Emergency Stance is currently bugged. It never goes away. Once it's triggered, it's 65 damage reduction for the rest of your expedition, which is silly. It's ridiculous, and that's now the only survivability mod that I rock because it's all I need. And I will use the Anomaly Effigy for pretty much my whole expedition with Concentration Blast and Killing Spree to kill as many things as I can because this has AoE damage. And then for the one shot at the boss, I'll switch to a Fortress Gravedigger's Frenzy Enoch's Blessing. Once again, you do not need the Enoch's Blessing. Anything with Gravedigger's Frenzy and Fortress will do, but a purple pump shotgun could be even better here. And you could honestly even use a one shot rifle like the Molten Edola with Fortress on it, because this will have a higher crit multiplier on it, which will give you even more damage. You would have to change your skill tree a little bit to spec out a shotgun damage, but that is also super, super solid. And then skill tree doesn't change. Obviously, some of these things like Sharp Eye and Bloodlust aren't great when you're one-on-one with a boss and you don't have anything to kill. However, in solo, the health of enemies is so much lower than in three players that you can pretty much get away with either just killing an add or two and then shooting at the boss, or just shooting the boss and killing them in like one to two shots, and and you should be good. Guys, that is it for the video. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned something new. Obviously, it's not super realistic to get all these pieces of gear and to get the setup with three people, but I hope you learned something about what mods you should be using to do the most damage and a little bit about Trickster. I will catch y'all in the next one. Take care, guys. Peace. I was putting-